Holy fucking shit. That was wild. That was absolutely fucking bonkers.
Mitch, stop. I have to censor all of that.
I know, that's the point.
Yeah, man.
Stop. Do you know how much extra time it takes me to have to censor this shit? And I don't remember it happens. I sit down to edit an episode. I'm like, oh, this is going to be easy. And then immediately I'm with like, oh, I got to find like 8 funny sound effects to put over the thing. And now I'm swearing too, and I'm making it worse for myself. This is the worst intro we've ever had to a video before. Hate this.
Last week was amazing. I love Mega Man. And that video fucking rocks, dude.
Was that like a Rockman joke? Like it rocks because it's like Rockman?
Shut up!
I want to keep the ball rolling on Mega Man. Unfortunately, today's video is Yu-Gi-Oh! So I'll have to improvise a bit. So swinging straight into round one.
Oh shit.
The theme is Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards that could be Robot Masters.
What does that even fucking mean?
Your four options are Searchlight Man, Jaws Man, Sonic Man, and Oil Man.
Oh, I get it. I get it now.
I feel like I've experienced whiplash with how this episode began. I haven't said a word, and I've just been sitting here a bystander.
Oh, that was a lot.
But now you can. I am encouraging you to speak. What is your answer, Kyle?
This has got to be Jaws, man, dude. We're back. I'm back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Where I throw something out there because I know zero things about Yu-Gi-Oh! Other than the quote, fair. Yugi boy.
Who said that quote, Kyle?
My boy.
Don't fucking know.
Who said that quote, Kyle?
Me, just now. I just said it. So I'm quoting myself.
Damn, fake fan.
Please attribute that quote to Kyle in the comments.
I'm going to update the wiki.
Kyle Steinle, fueled by sandwiches.
I'm going to Photoshop your face over Pegasus.
Yeah, I'm gonna Photoshop the Millennium Eye into your fucking face.
Who's your favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Robot Master?
Nico, I want you to go next.
Yeah, it's gonna be Oil Man.
Okay. See, my logic here, Oil Man is a real Robot Master. Sonic Man, technically a real Robot Master because there was a Sonic crossover, multiple Sonic crossovers in the Archie comics, and Sonic Man technically existed, I think. Searchlight Man is very close to Search Man, which is from Mega Man 8, which is my favorite Mega Man game. So I'm going to go Jaws Man because there's no parallels between...
It's time to put the nerd alert over Tyler's.
Oh wait, no, actually that doesn't make any sense because only one of them is fake. I was doing it back. Well then never fucking mind. Now I have no idea.
Yep.
Who guessed what? Yeah. Kyle, you guessed Jaws Man. What did you guess, Nico?
Oil
Man. Well, I'll guess something different. I'll go Searchlight Man. Fuck it.
Wow. My man gave us a fucking like thesis and like shit. And he goes, fuck, I don't know. What'd you guys pick?
I realize I played myself, okay?
Just wait, shit. There's that theory. All right. Number
three. I was like Tyler. So in the zone, and then I realized it was just asked backwards because we were guessing the real one or the fake one and not the real one.
Tyler, I'm gonna need you to submit to me a 4-page, 5-paragraph single space essay about how you gave us all of that background and we're still wrong. There are no points on the board. The fake card is Sonic Man.
Fuck off.
That's a shame.
Wow. Jaws Man is exactly what my paralysis demons told me it was. Searchlight Man is incredible.
I love Searchlight Man.
Such a great design. Like, bravo. I love it.
It's giving a little bit of like Siren Head.
A little bit, yeah.
But it's also like, hitting a pose that I've seen Shadow hit. So, like,
shut the fuck up.
And as we know, there nothing goes more with Shadow the Hedgehog than Searchlights.
Well, yeah.
Searchlight Man really had to do it to him.
That's actually what's underneath all the fur for Shadow.
Oh, yeah.
Is he just peels it off and he's just made of Searchlights, actually.
Those are the Shadow androids.
Yeah, see, exactly.
Can we move on?
Jaws Man is my favorite Sonic OC, personally. Jaws Man the Mouth Hog. That's my favorite Sonic character.
What kind of top he give though?
That's what we like to know.
Not good.
Which mouth do you think he primarily gives head with? He's got
Can
a lot.
We move on?
Round two has it definitely has a theme, but I'm gonna ask you to tell me what the theme is after I tell you what the four options are.
Okay.
Horny.
Your options are Masked Hero Searchlight, Big Jaws, Sonic Duck, and Oil.
So these are just the same things as before?
Yeah.
No. He asked us to answer the question, and the question that he asked was the theme. What is tax evasion?
No, you're right.
That's
a better guess.
They're all giving. Yeah.
I think the theme is I hate my friends. Fuck you. That's the theme you went with here.
That's the theme I've been getting all night. What a
it's evident.
I really like Sonic Duck to be real so badly.
So that's not your answer? Which one's fake?
No, that is my answer. I think that's fake because I like it too much.
Okay.
I'm going to go with Big Jaws.
Okay.
I think you made Hero in all caps to throw us off.
Oh, all right.
I think it's fake.
Okay.
And Oil has to be a card.
Oil has to be. There's no fucking way.
Oil was very clearly a real card.
Like they day one sat down in the writer's room. Yeah. Like, what cards are we gonna make? Well, Oil.
Yeah. I'm surprised there's not also just a man card. Like
yeah.
Three staple cards: Oil, People Running About, and Pot of Greed.
Everyone's favorite.
An interdimensional purple thorny dick, or whatever the card is called.
Get your own Yu-Gi-Oh! Crossover on baddragon.com. We do have a point on the board, and that point goes to Kyle.
Ayo.
He's in the lead now. The fake card was Masked Hero Searchlight.
You're a sick fuck, because that's an actual naming convention in Yu-Gi-Oh! Cards.
Masked Hero is an archetype, and Hero is in all caps in the archetype.
That's why I didn't pick that one, because I thought I knew that was a thing. I thought I'd heard that before.
I didn't think he would play into it being a thing because none of us know enough about Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yeah, that was really shitty of you. Also, I don't know what I was expecting for Oil, but I'm underwhelmed.
Yeah, why did they just pick an image of not Oil actually? Like,
so
it's not even an Oil rig.
I am correct, and I could be wrong about this, but I believe Oil is only in the original card game right now and has not been ported to the trading card game. It happens, it will probably be assigned a new name.
What does that mean?
I don't know. That's just the facts.
You said that it's only in the card game right now. It hasn't been ported to the card game.
Yeah, that's correct. There's a difference between OCG and TCG, and I'm not going to get into it.
Oh, my God. I Yu-Gi-Oh.
I dislike Yu-Gi-Oh more and more.
Don't worry,
just
Tyler.
Every
look
little
at Sonic
trickle
Duck.
Of information I get
just
about
look
it.
At, just look at
just
Sonic
look at
Duck.
Sonic Duck.
Sonic Duck.
No, you're right. That does make me happier. Goated franchise. Mean? Holy shit.
Oh, wait. Hang on. A duck which can walk at a sonic speed. Sometimes he cannot deal with his incredible pace and loses control. Sonic Duck is my new favorite Yu-Gi-Oh card.
Oh, I knew Sonic Duck was going to be real.
So speaking of Sonic.
Oh, no.
Whoa, is that Flick the Bean?
The theme for round three is double alliteration. And that means there are two sets of alliteration in the card name.
Damn, that's a lot, bro. No.
Your choices are, tell me which one is fake. Emerging Emergency Rescued Rescue. Powerful Peoples versus Raucous Rioters. Putrid Pudding Body Buddies. And...
I've seen that. That's a porn. I've seen that one.
All right.
And Sour Scheduling Red Vinegar Vamoose.
What the actual fuck?
What is happening? Why is this popular with anyone?
Hey, real quick, is that a typo in Rescue to Ranger?
No.
No, oh, it's Rescue to Rescue. Oh.
Is Rescue a word?
No.
What?
They just wanted to make alliteration.
It's the wrong one. We're living in a world where Sour Scheduling Red Vinegar Vamoose is a real thing. I simply have to pick that as the fake one.
I'm also going to pick that one as the fake one.
I. That's not fun then.
Well, it's just the only one that's hyphenated. I have nothing else to base it off of.
Putrid Pudding Body Buddies. I'm shifting because that one's the one that made me laugh the most.
I want that one to be real more than I've ever wanted anything in my entire life.
I honestly can't wait to see the three that are real because I can't see any of these having art.
I'm going to be a bitch. I'm also choosing Sour Scheduling.
Okay.
So I switched to Body Buddies just so we know that it's not only on one.
Uh-huh. Sure. Yeah. No, absolutely.
The feud exists as a chat. I just want to. Can we just. The one that's a fake word in it is not getting picked.
No, it's very clearly real. It's very clearly real.
It's very clearly real.
Yeah.
There is. It's so difficult to believe that any of these cards are real. But when I tell you that there are still. There's still just one point on the board after you guys guess this question.
Is it the Powerful Peoples?
Powerful Peoples versus Raucous Rioters is the one I made up.
That was the only one I was going to guess. But the reason I went with Sour Scheduling is because of the word vamoose. That is such a U word. I did not believe. Oh.
They're not that putrid.
No. They're not. Nah. Also, it's flan. Like, it's just like they are flan.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest with you. I really like the art of all of these cards except for Sour Scheduling Red Vinegar. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I was not expecting Vinegar Train. I'm kind of disappointed by that one.
I knew the name before I saw the card and I had the same reaction.
Is it like a play on Caboose? Is that the idea?
No, I think it's Vamoose because it's getting out of Dodge.
Yeah.
Like Vamoose, Caboose.
Vamoose.
Yeah, like, those do rhyme, Kyle. You are correct. Those are rhyming words.
It could have kept going and it would have made sense.
Just stop.
Yu-Gi-Oh's breaking me, guys.
Trying to make sense of it.
It's the rescue card is rescute because they are cute.
Oh, so.
I get it. They are cute.
That's what it was.
They come from an entire archetype where every single card has a pun in its name. Anyway.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Update Putrid Pudding Body Buddies is my new favorite card.
Okay. All right. Someone update the wiki.
Yeah.
The few of us. I'm excited to see what your reaction is going to be to the theme for question number four because it's math.
Oh my god.
Your choices are equations.
I'm going to be so fucking irate.
Your choices are damage equals reptile, linear equation canon, math mech addition, and literally the quadratic formula.
I'm going to pick the quadratic formula, and if that is real, I'm going to scream.
When we see the results, I think you'll be angry.
Is that the text on the card, or is it like just something you said? Because I could have seen that being the subtext on the card, Neo.
Oh shit! Math Mech Edition. I'm choosing. I don't.
I need the universe to know this and our viewer base that this is like so much worse than Digimon. Like this is so much worse. Like this is actually bad.
It's so much funnier. It's so much funny. Yeah.
A little, but it's so fucking
ridiculous.
Digimon is so cool. I love Digimon. I'm going to get a Digimon
tattoo.
Wow,
what a fucking turncoat. Karn EX talked about you once and you're
I'm shilling now. it's something called perspective. I'm going with damage equals reptile.
Okay.
Second times get tough, you turn tail, you sick fuck.
Turning tail from the greater evil.
What?
Spend a while, enjoy yourself, shut the fuck up.
Okay, what? So
what is happening?
I haven't recovered. I haven't recovered from winning the Mega Man game. I'm not going to recover.
Spoilers for the Mega Man game. That was hype as fuck.
Yeah.
But Tyler, you said that your guess was the quadratic formula?
Yes.
Okay. We have a tie now. Tyler and Kyle both have 1 point. I made up the quadratic formula.
Thank you. I was literally going to flip my fucking desk.
I was so excited to see the quadratic formula on the card, though.
I want to make sure you guys know.
Wow.
The title of the card, Damage Equals Reptile, is Damage Equals Reptile. It's just that the printing on the website I took all of the art from, for some reason, just has a big dash instead.
Weird.
It Damage Equals Reptile.
Okay. Roast him in the comments below. Tell him how much of a fucking idiot he is.
I love linear equation canon.
It has one of the most convoluted effects in the entire game because you genuinely have to do math.
Oh my god, there's so much text. Wait, declare a whole number from 1 to 6. Choose one effect monster your opponent controls. Multiply the effect monster's level X, the declared number. Then add the number of cards to your opponent controls and check if the result equals the number of cards in your GY. If yes, send cards from the top of your deck to the graveyard up to the declared number. And if you do, shuffle cards your opponent controls into the deck up to the number you sent to the graveyard. If no, you lose life points equal to the declared number times 500. You can only activate one per turn.
Hey
guys, Yu-Gi-Oh sucks. Hey guys, so Yu-Gi-Oh sucks.
How in the world is this like the most popular card game?
It's funny
ever
because I'm showing you the worst of it.
No, Nico, it's funny because we're reading it and laughing about it here, but people play this game and do that in the game. Like they actually have to do what you just said in a turn of a game.
I think
it's crazy.
I have never heard of anyone ever using any of the cards I have listed today, by the way.
Why do they exist?
Because they were printed. What do you mean? They don't use every single card in the game.
What, you've never had a bad idea?
Any card game, no one is going to use every card at the same time.
Mm. I mean, yes, but like...
Pokemon especially. Do you think that half the fucking cards that they have in the Pokemon game are viable at all? No, some of them are just like a fish that does zero damage. Why would you ever put that in your fucking deck?
They have the entire card game and Guzzlord. Guzzlord is the only usable Pokemon. Anyway, round five. The theme for round five is extraordinarily vague descriptions.
Neat.
Your options are the thing in the crater, magical something, this creepy little punk, and that.
That was called in high school. This is crazy.
Holy shit.
Oh my god.
This creepy little punk.
This creepy little punk is going to give his magical something to the thing in that crater.
The crater is going to go, that?
No, listen. The juxtaposition from Kyle's response to you saying extremely vague descriptions immediately into the thing in the crater was such amazing. A fucking slingshot.
That was amazing.
Oh, I'm having such a good time. Tonight is awesome. First Mega Man in this now. This started out awesome,
and it took a turn. It took a turn in a different direction. I'm going to go with this creepy little punk. I think you made up this creepy little punk. I think you just thought, "What am I? I'm this creepy little punk. I'm gonna write myself down."
I'm going to choose magical something.
Yu-Gi-Oh, you have one chance. One chance to regain some kind of semblance of respect I have for you. My choice is that.
Okay. All right.
Uh-huh.
And what's it got to do?
If that is real, I'm upset. I'm very upset. Oil, at least it's a thing. That is just like
it's that.
It's just that.
Right. It's that. Yeah, what's up? It's that.
What's the problem? So that's my choice.
Yeah.
Oh man, Kyle is feuding with Yu-Gi-Oh tonight.
I'm always feuding with Yu-Gi-Oh. I'm feuding with
Yu-Gi-Oh. But we are calling a truce in question number five because that is the fake card.
Okay.
I thought I remembered.
I thought it was too good to be like too crazy to be fake, especially after the quadratic formula.
Oh, same. That's why I went with it. I thought it'd be fun.
I remembered there being a card called that. There are multiple one word ambiguous cards.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Just not that.
the art in magical something is way too cool to be called magical something.
I know, right?
Yeah, like it's literally like Thanatos. Like what the hell?
Yeah. No, they drew it first and went, what do we call it?
Oh fuck, this ships today.
Also, why is creepy little punk like a Western shot?
Yeah, like that's not creepy.
I figured if it was gonna be anything, it was gonna be like a dude with like a mohawk and a leather jacket, shirtless, pumping his veins full of hard drugs and jerking off in like a back alley somewhere. Like I was expecting that. And we got a cowboy.
That is a different card.
This card is always treated as an infinity card.
Yeah. In the bonus round, I'm going to give Nico the opportunity to tie and Tyler the opportunity to win because it's worth 2 points.
Whoa, crazy.
The theme is repeating sounds. Your options are rough roughing roughhousing, some summer summoner, made to order mermaid outfit outfitter, and nitwit outwit.
That's a good one. That's the only good one. That's the only good card. So it's fake. I'm picking nitwit outwit.
These aren't as bad as I was expecting. I was expecting something akin to like bo 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 or like.
Oh no, know, no 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 no. No, Mr. Bo, they wouldn't do that. They wouldn't do that.
They're all stupid. Don't give credit.
They wouldn't do that at all.
Some summer summoner.
I'm gonna go with made to order mermaid outfit outfitter because that just sounds like something that that Mitch would like Google search in his free time. It's just like for personal reasons.
I'm going on the deep dive.
No pun intended.
Bro got access to your search history.
Well, I just have access to his friendship and I know what he likes.
I know what he likes.
Access to his friendship.
We do have a winner in this final round.
Well, so I didn't get it.
And that winner is Kyle, because you all got this one wrong. I made up rough roughing roughhousing.
God damn it.
Damn.
Wow.
The shit sucks. Stop asking us to do these.
Please don't make us do Yu-Gi-Oh! Anymore.
This I have so upset. Many more quizzes I could make.
I know.
All Yu-Gi-Oh!
This sucks. And the problem is that we're upset, visibly upset, so people are going to want more of it.
Ask for more. I have more.
I just need to like sit here for one of these episodes, make no comments, make no noise, and just give answers. And they'll be like, wow, this sucks. Let's not do Yu-Gi-Oh! Anymore.
Yeah, and then everyone will unsubscribe, and then we'll just like...
But at least I won't have to deal with this.
What do you guys think of Some Summer Summoner?
I love it. I love it. Yeah, love it a lot.
Raikage.
It's literally the guy from Lilo and Stitch, but with hair. Like the ice cream guy. Oh, you're right. You know who I'm talking about?
Yeah. And also, also no weird tan line.
Because he's like, he's got all the sun up there.
I kind of love.
He's probably
that,
got a tan line where that thong be.
So that was this newest episode of Yu-Gi-Oh! I had an absolute blast, and I hope that you really enjoyed all of our uncensored swearing right at the beginning.
I hope you enjoyed that. You know, why is it always Yu-Gi-Oh? Why is it never Uskio?
That sucks.